Today I'm going to show you how to integrate Google Assistant with Home Assistant Cloud, so you can control your entities from any Google Assistant device without exposing your Home Assistant to the internet. I'm also going to show you how to configure what entities can be controlled via Google Assistant and how to customize the response when a command is given. Open Home Assistant and on the sidebar, click on Configuration and then Home Assistant Cloud. If this is the first time using the cloud service, you can sign up and get a 30-day free trial, and then after that it's $5 a month, which is not a lot for all the features that you get, plus the security that you don't have to expose your Home Assistant to the internet. After you're signed in, enable the Google Assistant integration. Then you need to enable the Has.io skill for Google Assistant. So open the Google Home app on a mobile device, tap on Add, Setup Device, and then tap Have Something Already Set Up. Search and select Has.io, then sign in to Home Assistant Cloud and tap on Allow Access. After Has.io is linked, another page comes up with some of the entities that you have in Home Assistant. To see a list of all your entities and assign them to specific rooms, go back to the main Google Home window, go to Account, Settings, Assistant, and then Home Control. Alright, so Google Assistant is now integrated with Home Assistant, and you can start controlling your entities from any Google Assistant device. To trigger entities that have an on and off switch, for example a light, you can simply say, turn on living room light, and then the Google Assistant would turn the light on and then provide you with an appropriate response. However, entities like automations or scripts, for example, a script to lock your computer, you wouldn't be able to just say, lock computer. You would actually have to say, activate, and then the name for the script. The response back will be something like, okay, activating PC lock. There's a couple of ways that you can customize this and make it simple to execute a simple script or an automation. For example, you can use routines in Google Assistant and customize the way you ask to execute an action, but you wouldn't be able to change the assistant response. However, you can use IFTTT to customize both the way you ask for something and also the way Google Assistant responds back. Let me show you an example of how to set up both methods using the script to lock my computer. If you want to use routines, on the Google Home app, tap on the routines icon, manage routines, and then the plus icon to create a new one. Enter the phrase or phrases that you would like to say to trigger the command. Then tap on add action and enter the actual phrase that would trigger the script or the automation entity. On this example, it will be activate PC lock. Save the changes, and then anytime you say the phrase on the routine, it will execute the action that was set up. If you want to use IFTTT to be able to customize the way Google Assistant responds back, you will need to first set up the following in the automation.yaml file. Then on the Home Assistant Cloud page, enable the IFTTT webhook. After that, go to the IFTTT page and click on New Applet. Then click on this, search and select Google Assistant, and select Say a Simple Phrase. Now enter the phrase or phrases that would trigger the script or the automation entity. Then on the bottom, enter the phrase that you would like the Google Assistant to say in response. Click on Create Trigger, then click on that, search and select Webhooks, and select Make a Web Request. Now copy the IFTTT webhook from the Home Assistant Cloud page and paste it in the URL field on the IFTTT page. Change the method to post, the content type to application JSON, and then under body, enter the following to trigger the specific Home Assistant entity. After that, click on Create Action, and then Finish. Now let's go ahead and put it to a test. Hey Google. Lock computer.
Okay, locking computer.
All right, so it pretty much ran the command that I wanted. and it gave me a better response. The last thing that we're going to look at is how to configure in Home Assistant the entities that can be controlled from Google Assistant and which ones to exclude. Also, how to change the name for the entities, add aliases, and assign them to specific rooms. Alright, in your Home Assistant config folder, create a new file and name it cloud.yaml. Then, in the configuration.yaml file, add the following to the cloud component. After that, open the cloud.yaml file and add the following. Under filter, there are a few variables that you can use. So depending on your setup and the number of entities that you would like to expose to Google Assistant, you can either use include entities, which will only expose the list of the entities that you specify, or exclude entities, which exclude the entities in that list. Alternatively, you can either use include domains or exclude domains, which can either include or exclude all the entities inside of a specific domain. Now, to configure how entities are exposed to Google Assistant, you can use the variable entity_config. With this, you can change the entity's name, add aliases, and also specify the location of the entity within the home. I personally suggest setting this option for the entities exposed to Google Assistant, so like that if you unlink and then relink the HasIO skill, it would automatically set all the entities to specific rooms. Otherwise, you will have to manually assign them via the Google Home app. After you finish making changes to the cloud.yaml file, restart Home Assistant and then sync the updates to Google Assistant by simply asking, "Hey Google, sync my devices." Alright guys, that's all I have for you today. Remember to check the written guide on my website for any changes. You can find a link in the description below. Also, stay tuned for the next video where I will show you how to integrate Amazon Alexa with Home Assistant Cloud. Like always guys, thank you for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, and I will see you in the next video.